Hello everybody, today we'll be creating an AppClip experience. We will be generating AppClip QR codes with a tool provided by Apple. Then we will read these QR codes to launch an AppClip. This experience will create a card, which when tapped will present a portion of the app that we did in a previous exercise, RestApp. We will then make it so that the AppClip is capable of handling different QR codes to present different experiences. As I mentioned, we will be creating the AppClip experience from the REST app, an application that I will link the playlist below. We have been working on for 10 different exercises, including deep links. Here, we will just add another target to include the AppClip experience. When we created the target, we added these files. So we have another Swift UI app to deal with, and we have a content view. So let's run it and see what happens. And as you can see, we have now a new app. For the next step, we're going to be generating the AppClip code. And to generate this code, Apple provides an AppClip code generator, so you can download it from the developer.apple.com website. And once you download it, you can use it with Terminal. The first step for generating an AppClip code is deciding what are going to be the colors. So we're going to first create a code with a color yellow. Here I'm creating an asset color just to show you the color. It's going to be this one. And now that we have the background color, we will use this tool to suggest a new color. So what you do is start with the command AppClip code generator suggest --foreground. For now, let's specify white in hexadecimal. And the background, this is the color that we want. So the tool suggests several colors. And we can choose one of those. Let's choose this one. Now you can know that you have a good combination, because if you try again the suggest command with this set of colors, you'll get back only those pair of colors. So that's, you're good to go. The next step is deciding the URL that the code will have. Now for this, we'll use the generate command, since now we're generating the AppClip code. So we start with --URL. We type in the URL that we'll be calling, that the AppClip code will have embedded. In this case, it's going to be example.restapp.com/restaurant1. For the foreground and background color, we'll just use the pair that we have decided on. And then the output, which is the file where we're going to be storing the AppClip code. So we're going to do this in desktop, and let's call it restaurant1. This is an SVG. And there we have it, AppClip code successfully generated. Now let's see the file. Here it is. There you can see the two colors that were combined. We're going to open it with Chrome to display the SVG, since I don't want to have a preview window open the entire time. Now what I need to do is make it so that when I aim the phone here with the camera, it prompts an AppClip card that if I want to, will open the AppClip. To do this with a production app, you need to configure the experience on Testflight. Now, because we don't want to upload this to Testflight, there is a way to create a trigger in the phone to test out this experience before you ship your app. Because I will need a camera to read the AppClip code, I'm going to be using my phone. We're not going to use the simulator. To create this trigger that I was mentioning, you need to go to the settings in your phone, go to developer, and go to local experience. There you will register a new experience where you can add everything necessary to display the card. So first, it will be the URL that we added to the AppClip code. So it needs to be exactly the same URL. So that way the phone knows that when reading this URL, it needs to open your app clip. And how does it know that? Because you're going to match the bundle ID in this local experience to that of your app clip. Next, we need to add the title and the subtitle. So here we just add some text that will catch the user's attention. Then you need to decide the name of the CTA that will that the user will tap to open the app clip. You can just decide on three options. And then we will add an image that will be displayed in the app clip card to the user. And that's all you can do. You cannot customize further the card that is presented to the user. You can add subviews, do anything. That's all that we have control of over the experience for now. So now let's go to the device. Let's open up the camera, read the code. As you can see, this is the interface with iOS 15, by the way. And once we read the AppClip code, we can display the card that we just created in the local experience. Notice how at the bottom, we can always take the user to the main app. The AppClip will always be a link to the main app. Once inside, we also get a reference to the main app, and we get the AppClip experience that we're now going to customize. Before moving on to the code, let's create a second QR. Since we have a restaurant app, we want to be able to generate different AppClip codes to present AppClip experiences for different restaurants. So we'll follow the same steps with another color to generate a different AppClip code with a different URL. Here's the other AppClip code. Let's now register a different local experience. And now we can move on to the code. First off, we'll capture the URL that we're getting called with by reading the AppClip code. We'll do that by reading from the NS user activity using a modifier in Swift UI. We're going to be doing all of this in the view, which is why we are going to create a view model. For now, our view model will just have a published variable, source name, and their source name will capture from the last path component of the web page URL in the NS user activity that we're going to get from the view modifier. And then we'll add the source name to the view. Oh. I just realized that when I upgraded to Xcode 13, the size of my font switched back to small. Apologies for that. Let's change it to big again. Let's link the view model, and now we're ready to test this out. Let's try reading this other QR code, the second one we generated. So we have this new, the different experience. Tap on open. and we are not reading from the URL. Let's see, where did I mess up? Oh yes, it's not user activity, it's uncontinued user activity, because we're opening from another activity, which is of type browsing from web. Now let's run again. Okay, let's try it once more. We'll read again from the AppClip code. Let's open it. And much better. Now we have the restaurant too. Now let's improve this AppClip experience a little bit more. So we show some text, the image that belongs to that restaurant, and a CTA to, let's say, order a free sample from the restaurant. It's not gonna be real. But what's important is after ordering that free sample, because we already gave a taste to the user of what the real app could do, we're gonna prompt the user to download the main app. The pictures that we are showing right now in the AppClip card were from the main app. They don't match the restaurant one and restaurant two, so let's make changes in the names of the images and the assets of the main app. We will add some dummy text for the description. This is not relevant for the exercise. The only part that we are missing now is what we will do when the user taps on order a free sample, which is promoting the main app. To do this, we will need to use StoreKit. And we'll use another SwiftUI modifier, which is the App Store overlay. So just like the sheet and alert modifier, this one needs a binding bool, which will be part of the state of the view. And this is this state is the one that we will toggle when the user taps on the button. The second parameter expects a closure that returns an SK overlay configuration. The configuration that we're returning is an AppClip configuration. And we decide the position, which is going to be the bottom. Now let's try running this. Okay, so now we have the AppClip experience installed. Keep in mind, this is not something that the user has to do. This is just because we are testing locally, but the user will never see that empty state because they will always display these by reading from an AppClip code. Okay, so we read from the AppClip code. We tap on open. There we have our experience. We are prompted to download the main app. We see the description. Let's tap on order free sample. And there we have the other prompt that we can give to the user. On a real app in production, when they tap on that, they will be taken to the app store. So everything is working. Let's try doing the same for the other AppClip code. And that was all. App clips are definitely an interesting experience. Keep in mind that they need to be lightweight. They have a limit size of 10 megabytes. They are just meant to be a sample of the app so that the user can get a taste of the main app and feels motivated to download it. Testing it on your own device is also really easy by registering a local experience. And keep in mind that your main app should be ready to also process the URL from the AppClip code, since it's possible that a user that already has the app installed reads from the AppClip code with their own device. That was all. Hope you liked it. Bye.